Dune, the adaptation of the Frank Herbert classic by very critically acclaimed director Denis Villeneuve. I was so excited for this, as well as countless millions of other Dune fans. This is probably one of the most anticipated sci-fantasy releases of the last decade. No exaggeration there. You hear one of the best working directors is adapting one of the all-time classics from the sci-fi genre, and nerds are gonna be interested. And before I get into the praise and criticism, I just want to get something out of the way. This is clearly an adaptation that succeeds in being a work of extreme commitment and passion. The visuals and details realized here are so many and just brilliantly immersing the viewer into the world of Dune. And so, as someone who's not a tremendous Dune fan to begin with, I personally found myself very well transported into this world, and it felt like the people behind the scenes put everything they had into doing the best they could into bringing Dune to life, and that itself is such a pleasure to experience. So, on the enjoyment level, yeah, this movie got some free brownie points from there, as well as having the visual style of Denis Villeneuve, who I am just in love with, and I was set up to just go in positive. But unfortunately, this is a movie where I do have some pretty heavy criticisms, and I want to start out with those so that we can then end on the positives. First off, this movie is a part one of two. No, the second movie's not going to cover the second Dune book. Instead, the first Dune book has been split up, and this is covering roughly about half of the first Dune book. From a writing perspective, the structure of how they decided to spend their time and what to focus on was very confusing for me. And as someone who's not personally very invested in the character of Paul, because I find him to be rather bland. Yes, I'm sorry, I can't get over that. I find this character to just be one that, on face value, I don't like that much. And aside from the sequences that were focusing on the elements that this narrative did manage to invest me in, mainly the politics and maneuvering there, I just wasn't super emotionally into this film. Like, it just didn't hook me with those big meaty hooks in the way that I really wanted it to. And it feels like partially because they played it pretty safe in terms of this adaptation. I know fans usually want people to be as die hard close to the source material as they can, but Dune in particular is a movie I thought could really have benefited from some reimagining in a key few ways, especially around the character of Paul. Adding some more personality and flair to that character, I feel like could have done a lot to this movie's benefit, because once we were just following him more closely, Not really in love with anything that happened. And there was surprisingly some choices to remove scenes that were specifically devoted to character development within the book that were really sorely needed here, especially for Paul. And so what we ended up was a weaker version of this character that is present in the book, which I hate to say. And there's one particular scene in the book involving a dinner scene that I swear I remember. It's been a minute since I read it because I read it for the initial release date. Oops. But that scene did a lot for what this movie was lacking for character for me. The first half of this film, much more into. But the second really started to lose me. Now, very often when you criticize a movie's structure, people take that as a pacing criticism. And with how slowly paced this movie is, I feel like I'm gonna get lumped into a crowd that has a problem with that, but I don't. I really like the slower pacing. This is an epic, and it deserves to be treated as such. And so I have no problem with this film deciding that I need to just experience this world that has really successfully been created. So despite what some other people might say, I enjoy when this movie is going to indulge itself in that sense, especially when the visuals are so spot on again and again. The smaller details in this movie and how good they look was just so rewarding as a fan of the genre. Just my God. I really try to keep track of like how many wonky shots I see in a movie that straight up pulled me out of it. And there was only one visual effect where I went, eh, as something on a ship kind of inflates in the background that I went, that didn't look awesome. Aside from it though, spectacular. And that's not even mentioning them big old worms. Oh God, did they do everything in terms of impact and feel that I wanted them to. I actually watched it again at home with headphones on, and in the theater, I've seen this movie twice now, judge me. And in the theater, there was just so much feeling in the air when they emerged. Wow. Stupendous. And then there's, of course, just the color palette and the choices of direction that make this truly succeed in capturing that feeling that so many movies and shows that try to portray an epic fail to do of earning that genre title.
Epic!
All of that's great. But I still have a couple more criticisms here. This one's actually a mixed bag. I loved the battles. I have no other way to put it aside from they were heavy. The drama was so effective, and seeing characters have last stands and final charges and stuff was brilliant. That was all really well done. The shields, in some scenes when the choreography was clearly working with them effectively, I thought were really great. But then there were a couple weird movements and usages that I either found a bit inconsistent or just made them kind of go, hey, that was, what was that? And then there's a final duel at the end that I just don't feel like came across as dramatic as it was supposed to, but that's going to be subjective. I think some people are going to like the way that the emotions conveyed there. I just wasn't super swept up in it. Probably because I'm just not connecting with characters here. I have a massive crush on Oscar Isaac, and so his portrayal of the leader of House Atreides, I was nervous he'd come across a bit too young, a bit too inexperienced, but no. He is probably my favorite performance of this movie. He just made so many small choices as an actor with this character that managed to convey the gravitas of the leader of House Atreides, as well as the experience of who this man is, and then followed up with a lot of heart and love that just seems so genuine. A masterful portrayal from Oscar Isaac, in my opinion. Praise, though, really, from the rest of the cast, from Jessica to Duncan Idaho, all of them, really a lot of personality and charm. Dave Bautista, I like seeing him in more stuff like this. Is it with him in serious roles I like. I need to watch this one more time before I firmly have an opinion on his performance here. I just think that Timothée Chalamet, unfortunately, was handed a kind of bland saltine cracker of a character. I'm stuck in a weird place for my final numbered review because I enjoyed the first half of this a lot, and I was never bored or not interested, but I was never emotionally compelled after the second act was over. So I'm sitting at a very light 7, and I'm left wondering two things. How will I feel about this movie in a few years, because I really don't know. The taste in my mouth is strange. And then finally, why am I so excited for the second film? I think it's because I know it's going to focus more on Zendaya's character, which obviously, I'm not going to get into spoilers for Dune if you don't know who that is, but it's interesting. It's going to be Sean. Good. And two, the focus of what's left of the narrative very much so involves what this movie managed to get me into, the politics, how well there's going to be, you know, revolutions, things like that. So I really care about what was set up. I just didn't love the setting it up. I stand by my rating. 7, light 7 out of 10. That's where we're going to be sitting. A very light, feathery 7. But let me know what you thought of Dune in the comments down below. It's available on HBO Max, which I watched and loved, and it's available in theaters, which I also did. I double watched Dune. Judge me. Hit the Patreon if you want to support what I do here. And buy the sequel to my first book, Rebels Creed, if you would like to support me in a more personal way. Have a good one, y'all. Peace.